right, now that's cross-threaded. So the factory running boards would start here and they would drop 9 inches, which is just high enough to be inconvenient. So I Googled average height of running board drops, and you get a lot of stuff when you Google average height. But anyway, the internet landed on 5 inches. So I'm gonna drop it 5 inches, make a little bracket that goes from there to there. And the top bolts will start here instead of the 5 inches up. And that will essentially make the running boards, let's see, start there, which is a nice, reasonable, I guess reasonable, but a nice compromise. So gonna go ahead and do that. So the running boards would have been up there, but instead we're gonna start them down here. And because of the type of running boards they are, it's actually gonna look kinda cool. Like it's a regular Ford factory drop down running board. All right, so I had this 20-foot strip of angle iron, and I made 12 strips out of it. These are gonna be my running board extensions. The running boards, because of the application, are a little higher than usual. So I'm gonna make some 8-inch drops to kind of hedge my bet, make it a nice halfway drop between an obnoxiously tall truck and where the running board should typically land. So ripped up these 12 pieces. Now we're gonna pop some holes in them and paint them up, and they'll just be basically some drop legs for the pinch weld on the side of the cab lip. All right, so all my plates are marked. I don't know if it matters if there's a left or right, but I did indicate that way. So now I put my special pilot hole and finish hole size bit on. That's a special bit. It does the pilot hole and the final hole at the same time. It looks like a regular bit, but it's not. It's also a pilot hole bit. So got the drop brackets on there and cinched down. It is super solid. Just show you what we did here. So if you're trying to lower your own, I guess amp step equivalent, these are Aries running boards. And like I said, they start out fixed as a step on their own. They typically would be really close to the top and really hug that rocker. I just cut those pieces at angle and drilled holes, and it's super, super strong. I really don't think it lost anything on integrity. I mean, we know that it did because that's adding a leverage point, but I don't feel any of the loss. Then once the step's deployed, gives you a nice two-step. This one's like right at 29 inches. And then you got 9 inches up from that, the next step, and then 9 inches up from that, the cab of the truck. But pretty pleased with how this turned out. If you have something comparable and you don't quite feel like the step comes down low enough, I would recommend that. That's a pretty easy to do job. These were 8 inches overall, and I think it was somewhere around like 3.5 or 4 inches is where I drilled the holes down. So it actually, the top hole on this bracket would have bolted up here. Does that make sense? And instead I just dropped it down and drilled another set of holes. But yeah, not bad for just some scrap metal I had laying around that I repurposed. So that'll be more usable and actually have a function instead of just the aesthetics of electric running boards that flip down. When you hit the button on it, there you go, easy access. So next week we'll go ahead and wire in the harness for it, and it'll open and shut when you open the door.